And caught by Cameron right side. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves his... Now a first down throw, Tannehill. He's going to loft one deep left side here.
Complete.
And every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Completed pass on second down. Now it's third down as the defense looks for the stop. Tannehill going to throw on third and one. It's complete to Graham. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. The offense lining up first and 10. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Now it's Tannehill. They dump off underneath to Ajayi. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Tannehill throwing again. They're dangerous wide receiver. Dolphins, and that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan, and
they're all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Kenny Stills, his first. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
He was trying to get it into his tight end Cameron that time. That'll bring up second down.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down.
So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Tannehill. And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here comes Ryan Tannehill now leading his offense back out there. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
On first down, it's Tannehill. Brought in over the middle by Graham. It's a gain of 14 there. And the Dolphins have a first down.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, the great coach said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down. Throwing on third down, Tannehill. And that is incomplete. after the interception. Here's Tannehill. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down. 10 yards still left on second down. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Offense trying to avoid stalling out. Face. Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
They showed off the athletic juke. Good little gain there, not a whole lot of real estate. Here's Colton Schmidt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets off a high, spiraling kick. Now this is fielded in the end zone. It's a net of 40 there. A punt of 48 and a return of 8. And the Dolphins' drive will start deep in their own territory with a first and 10. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But you also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Here's Tannehill now on second down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. And that catch puts him past the great Jerry Rice. For the most receiving yards in a single season, he's now up over 1,848.
At one point, we called Jerry Rice Flash. How about the dash we saw here today? The dash towards his record and past it. What a tremendous achievement. And how much fun is it for us to be here to witness it?
It's a pinch-me moment for us. In motion is Grant. Back to the air. Tannehill on second down. He sets to fight. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. It's a big play there for Miami. And even 40 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Well, there's simply no sense in wasting a great catch like that on a short gain. Get downfield like you just did there and use it up that way.
No dink and dunk. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Second and 10, Tannehill once more. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up third down. They'll come out in the pistol. To the air again, Tannehill. It's complete to Graham. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
Again, Tannehill, and he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Tannehill throwing again, and they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete. I can't imagine we'd see another throw here. Third and goal from the one. Throwing again is Tannehill. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up fourth. And out out come the Dolphins now. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. On first down, it's Tannehill. Brought in over the middle by Graham. 13 yards there on the pickup, and the Dolphins are going to get a first down. And there, the man coverage not good enough, partner, and they're able to complete the pass.
Excellent recognition of the man coverage, and they found the guy who could win downfield.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Miami after this. Tannehill on first down. And Cameron has it over the middle. 26 yards on the pickup there. And the Dolphins have a first down. Another pistol look here. Now a first down throw, Tannehill. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. Second down now after the incompletion. Second and 10, Tannehill. And over the middle, this is Parker. 11 yards for number 11.
This offense is in rhythm now, just accumulating first downs and moving the ball downfield.
From the red zone now, Tannehill. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execute.
And Stills has got it. Touchdown, Miami. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Here comes Grant on the return. They juked him. Comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. 10 yards to go on third. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Throwing on third down, Tannehill. And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first. After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. Now Damian Williams to return it. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line.
Illegal block in the back. Return team. Automatic first down.
On first down, Tannehill. And caught by Cameron right side. Evades the tackler and now some space. A big play there on the catch and run. And the Dolphins are going to get a fresh set of downs. Fresh set of downs here. On first and 10, Tannehill. And here he's got Graham. A good pickup there, a 22. So here we go, first and 10 now.
Dagger, dagger,
scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. Second and 10, Tannehill once more. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. In motion is Graham. Here's Tannehill. And he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably... After the TD, here's Carpenter on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here's Ryan Tannehill and the Dolphin offense back out onto the field. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind, it's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now there's probably a silent camaraderie that comes about him saying, hey.
And now the rookie's free. 30. And slips past him.
Where'd he go?
And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line.
Well, you don't have to wait till you get to the red zone to run the fade. It can be effective in any part of the field.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed...
Blitz coming, and down he goes. The rookie from Clemson, Shaq Lawson, in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Well, this defensive unit certainly picked a great time to make a stand. Back-to-back sacks, starting with first and goal. Have to believe that they'll continue to bring the pressure on third down.
They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. Here's Colton Schmidt now as he's on to punt for Buffalo. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. And they'll get to this and touch it, looks like, yeah, right at the 15-yard line here. And the Dolphins offense now ready to go back out on the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Back to the air, Tannehill on second down. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. To throw is Tannehill. It's complete to Graham. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
I know you don't get anything extra for degree of difficulty, but maybe you should. He's done absolutely everything in this game today, including laying out for that one.
In motion is Graham. Tannehill. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. And it's complete. The tight end, Deion Sims. A good pick up there of 20 yards. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
Second down following the incompletion. They come up in an offset eye. On second and 10, Tannehill. Brought in over the middle by Graham. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. This will be play number 7 on the drive. 3rd and a yard. In motion is Graham. Tannehill gonna throw on 3rd and 1. And he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably should have been their first. But here's Colton Schmidt now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. And now a high kick trying to pin him back. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yep. Run what
put
you
your
do
foot
best.
On the gas.
Exactly.
Offense.
Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
It's a loss of 10 yards on the play. Here's Tannehill. They dump off underneath to Ajayi. Ajayi hit. He lost the football. Now this is picked up by the Bills. So they've got the football, and they'll start right on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. And as the referee is under the hood, and we're seeing... Second down, here's Tannehill. Gonna throw right side here, complete. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. On first down, Tannehill. He's gonna loft one, deep left side here. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. A big play that time for the Dolphins. 62 yards.
Well, go ahead and throw the ball, man. You got the big lead. You got the clock on your side. Obviously, they don't care much about the feelings of the other team, do they?
Well, I was going to say, you better run to the locker room pretty quick after this one.
Well, right now, maybe. They're just looking at it from the fantasy perspective. More points for everyone if they win big.
Throwing again, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
It's always a good play when you're able to bat a ball away or...
Here's Colton Schmidt now. He's been terrific so far.
Let's go, let's go, let's go, guys.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And the Dolphins will start their drive at the 20-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays. But
and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. So Tannehill out. And in his place is the backup quarterback, Matt Moore. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And Cameron has it over the middle. Oh, he shifts past him. They'll get three out of the dump off there, and that'll lead to a third down.
And that's why defensive coaches preach swarming to the football. It's usually going to take more than one guy to get that big man down.
And it did right there. Multiple broken tackles, but they eventually get him down. It fights him off. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. Shaq Lawson in there to drop. And the Dolphins are going to recover. Comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
So second and 10 here. Moore now. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. Now Moore. Surveying the field. And he comes back with one complete. Time for a break. This one. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now it looks like he'll throw here. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And a big turn. Here's Colton Schmidt now as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.